India is one of the most diverse countries in terms of the sheer richness of varieties that are available. At any given estimate, we have about 110,000 plus varieties growing in India. And we are talking of the second largest crop in the world, that is about 120 million tons. So that's a huge number to digest.
The market is mature and stable. All the partners in the value chain have gained insight of the business and evolved with the time. Going forward, we see the growth in basmati consumption once COVID gets little settled down. As far as the next year is concerned, crop is good. Some varieties are short, some varieties are excess. Overall, you know, we see that, you know, the prices will be on the same, you know, as the last year.
Would like to highlight four key components of the supply chain, which starts from procurement, then for warehousing, then financing, and then the key and important role is the market linkage. In Origo, we are trying to give all solutions under one roof to automate the market linkages. One of our efforts is we are coming up with a product called TradeFi, and this is a technology based solutions. It will be supported by the blockchain, and where buyer, supplier, banker, or even the warehouse, all will be visible. There will be a transparency available, and it will be a very easy to use.
Paddy and rice especially, you know, makes a lot to the bank, because they are the major commodity where the supply chain is currently much better established than the previous year. You can track it, and it forms a major outstanding portion for the, you know, agri book.
A very structured and accurate survey of crop is done by at the institutional level. It will help our exporters. That's the first thing I want to point out, because that's a challenge. This industry is cost capital intensive, and there are expectations about government thinking of giving these incentives to the industry, which is contributing massively in the foreign exchange earnings to the government's exchequer.